बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर ज़ोरा नज़ीर कियानी अगेन हियर विद अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ एमएस कोर्स सेमीकंडक्टर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस। यू नो दैट वी आर स्टडिंग द पावर डिवाइसेस and so far we have studied the PNPN diode in which we have considered the four layer device with two terminals anode and cathode. Today we will consider the semiconductor control rectifier which is similar to PNPN diode, that it has also got four layers but it has got third terminal as well, which is known as the gate, that is it has got anode, cathode and gate. So today we will initially see that what is the semiconductor control rectifier is, and then we will see its gate control, and then how it can turn off from on state to the off state. Now this is the symbol of the silicon control or semi control rectifier, where you can see there is anode and there is cathode and the gate. You can see that there are three terminal present here. There is a gate terminal as well, along with the anode and with the cathode. And if you see in this figure, you can also see here three terminals which represent anode, cathode and the gate. Now basically the semiconductor control rectifier is useful in many applications, such as in power switching and in various control circuit. The device can handle currents from few milliamperes to hundreds of amperes, since it can turn on externally. The SCR can be used to regulate the amount of power delivered to a load, simply passing current only during selected portions of line cycle. A common example of this application is light dimmer switch used in many homes. At a given setting of this switch, an SCR is turned on and off repetitively, such that all or only part of each power cycle is delivered to the light. As a result, the light intensity can be varied continuously from full intensity to dark. The same control principle can be applied to motors, heaters, and many other systems. We shall discuss this type of application in this section after first establishing the fundamentals of device operations. And you must know that this device is often called a thyristor to indicate its function as a solid state analog of the gas thyristor. The thyristor is a gas filled tube that possesses current when an arc discharge occurs at a critical firing voltage. Analogous to the gate current control of the SCR, this filling voltage can be varied via voltage applied to third electrode. Now, among all power devices, SCR is most popular of the thyristor family due to its fast switching action, small size and high voltage and current rating. It is commonly used in power electronic applications. It has got three terminals, anode, cathode and the gate terminal. SCR is a turn on by applying a positive gate signal when anode is made positive with respect to cathode, similar to the PNPN diode. SCR is turned off by interrupting anode current by the voltage applied at the gate. The silicon control rectifier, a semiconductor control rectifier, is a two-state device used for sufficient power control. SCR is the parent member of the thyristor family and is used in high power electronics. Its constructional features, physical operation, and characteristics will be explained in the coming slides. Now here you can see the structure. Here you can see the structure of silicon control rectifier. Here its characteristics, and here its symbol, and also it will tell us its working as well. Here you can see that it is just similar to PNPN diode with three junctions J1, J2, J3, J1 near to anode, J3 near to cathode, and J2 in the center, along with the a gate terminal applied at the terminal near to base, near to the cathode, because you know that it is consisted of PNPN diode is consisted of two transistor PNP and NPN. So the gate is controlled to the base of the second transistor, that is NPN. Similarly, same IV characteristics you will obtain as you have obtained in case of PNPN diode. As you can see here, there is a forward blocking current. Then at a certain voltage applied, there is a certain holding current, and which will then convert to the saturation current. And in this region, it will be at on state. And when it will be the in forward blocking state, then current flowing through it will call as the latching current. Similarly, when the reverse bias is applied, here you can see the reverse blocking state, that is off state. And when you will increase the reverse voltage at a certain level, then you will get the reverse avalanche region. Hence, these all properties similar to PNPN diode, except this, we control this current which is flowing from anode to cathode, which started due to applying positive potential to the anode and negative potential to the cathode. It can be controlled with the help of the gate whose function was missing in the PNPN diode, which was considered as two terminal device. Now here you can see that this is anode, this is a cathode, and it is connected through a resistor with a varying voltage. Positive terminal is connected to the anode and negative terminal is connected to the cathode, and here gate is open. So in this form, this circuit is similar to PNPN diode. But when we will close this circuit, so that current will flowing through the gate, then the function of this current can be controlled, which is moving from anode to cathode. And again, this is the same curve, that is the IV characteristics which we have discussed for PNPN diode. And here is the symbol of SCR showing the gate terminal as well, and here is the two symbols. Now, as we have discussed, that up to a certain voltage, which is called the breaker voltage, in some case it is called the VP voltage, your SCR remain off. And when you will cross this voltage, then what will happen? This SCR will go to the on state, as we have seen in our simple PNPN diode. Now you know that we have discussed PNPN diode in detail, but here we will understand that what is function of this gate, which is connected to P2. So for this purpose, we will see that most important four-layer device in a power circuit application is the three-terminal SCR. This device is similar to PNPN diode, except that we have attached a gate to the one of the base region. When SCR is biased in the forward blocking state, that is forward blocking state, when now you can see here that we have shown the IV characteristics as well. When gate has zero current flowing through the gate, then we get this curve, this last curve. And when we applied certain gate voltage, then the saturation or forward block connecting state come at the lower voltage. Similarly, when we more increase this current through the gate, then again this is more reduced. That is, your device is set to the working condition, to the forward connecting state at a lower voltage. So when a SCR biased in the forward blocking state, a small current supply to gate can initiate switching to the conducting state. As a result, the anode switching voltage decreases as the IG current increases. This type of terminal control makes an SCR a useful and versatile device in switching and control circuit. Now we will visualize that how this gate is controlling this current. So to visualize the gate triggering mechanism, let us assume the device is in the forward blocking state with a small saturation current flowing from anode to cathode. A positive gate current causes hole to flow from the gate into P2. Here, from the gate, holes are flown inside the P2, the base of your NPN transistor. So here is the base of the NPN transistor, and holes are inducted into the this base P2. The added supply of holes and accompanying injection of electron from N2 in P2, as we have discussed earlier, that electrons move from N2 to P2 and holes move from P1 to N1. So here in this case, after we have triggered, after we have started, holes start moving from this P1 and moving toward the cathode, then we apply the gate voltage and gate will give the holes inside the P2. Similarly, some electrons will move from N2 to P2. Which initiates transistor action in the NPN. After a transit time tau 1, 2, the electrons, after a certain transit time tau, the electrons injected by J3, junction J3, the electrons which are injected J3 arrive at the center junction, arrived here, and are swept to the junction J1. So the electrons injected by J3, they arrive at center junction and are swept into N1, the base of our this P1 N1 P2 transistor. This causes an increase of hole injection of J1, and these holes diffuse across the base N1 in a transit time. Thus, after a delay time of approximately both transit time, that is the transit time which we have taken earlier, that is when electrons was injected by J3 and arrive at center junction, and the second transit time when these hole diffuse across the base N1 in transit time, one transit time moving here to here and other transit time for here to here. So indeed, thus after delay time of approximately total transit time, transistor action is established across the entire PNPN diode and device is driven into forward connecting states. In most SCR, the delay time is less than the few microseconds and the required gate current for turn on is only few milliamperes. Therefore, the SCR can be turned on by a very small amount of power in the gate circuit. On the other hand, the device current IA can be many amperes and the power controlled by a device may be very large. It means applying very few milliamperes at the gate can trigger this transistor action, and hence the current which we achieve at the output is many amperes. So the power delivered to the device which is working on this device is also will be very large. Hence, it is not necessary to maintain the gate current once the SCR switches to the connecting state. In fact, the gate essentially loses control of the device after regenerative transistor action is initiated. For most devices, a gate current pulse lasting a few microseconds is sufficient to ensure switching. Rating of minimum gate pulse height and duration are generally provided for particular SCR device. So you must have seen here that how application of third terminal in PNPN diode can make it more powerful and more application friendly by just receiving few milliamperes of current at gate and producing very high output current, and which can of course drive the many power devices. Okay students, our next step is that we have turned on device by moving it from forward blocking state to forward conducting state by applying the positive voltage at the base of the second NPN transistor, that is at P2. But the next step is the turning of the SCR. So here we will discuss the turning off of the CR. So this is basically turning off means changing from the conducting state to the blocking state, and it can be accomplished by reducing the current IA below a critical level, and that critical level is called the holding current. As I have discussed in the previous lecture that the current at the conducting state start is called the holding current. So if we move below a critical value called the holding current, then we can turn it to off, and this critical value of the holding current is actually required to maintain the alpha 1 plus alpha ratio equal to 1, which is the to keep the sum of the current transfer ratio of both transistor equal to 1. In some SCR devices, gate turn off can be used to reduce the alpha sum below unity. That is, we can use gate to reduce the alpha sum to unity. For example, if gate voltage is reversed, holes are extracted from P2 base region. If the rate of hole extraction by gate is sufficient to remove the NPN transistor from saturation, the device turns off. However, there are often problems involving the lateral flow of current in P2 to the gate. Due to non-uniform biasing of J3, it can result from the fact that the bias on this emitter junction varies with position when a lateral current flows. Therefore, SCADA device must be specifically designed for turn-off control at best. This turn-off capability can be utilized only over a limited range for a given device. It means it is discouraged to use gate to switch off this power device, that is SCR, because it will create certain problems. So to resolve this problem or improve the structure or construction of this device, here the two gates are used. One is connected to the base of transistor, first transistor, PNP, and second gate is connected to the base of the second transistor, NPN. It means one gate is connected to N1 and second gate is connected to N2. This type of device is often called a semiconductor control switch. The availability of the second gate electrodes provide additional flexibility in the circuit design. This semiconductor control switch, which is called the SCS, the SCS biased in the forward blocking state can be switched to the conducting state by the positive current pulse applied at the gate G2, as we have seen in the previous slide, or the negative voltage applied to the through gate G1 to base N1. If the device is designed for turn-off capability, separate circuits can be employed for turn on at one gate and turn off at other gate. It means we can use one gate to turn on the device and other gate to turn off the device. Other advantages of the semiconductor control switch configuration include the possibility of minimizing unwanted dV by dt switching. For example, the gate not used for triggering can be coupled to the nearest current terminal, that is G1. Gate G1 can be connected to the anode because it is near to anode, and G2 can be connected to the cathode to allow a charging path for J2 during a voltage transit between without causing inadvertent switching. So this is how our semiconductor control switch work. Here you can see these are symbolic representation of our two gate SCR. Here one G1, G2, and similarly two gates applied here. So this show the schematic configuration and common circuit symbols to show the two gate SCR, which is called the semiconductor control switch. At this, I have come to end of my lecture. Now, students, please answer my question in your Google class, which will mark your attendance as well. And inshallah ta'ala, I will see you in my another lecture. Allah Hafiz.